Hi, everyone. My name is Dan Bohus. I'm a researcher in the Adaptive Systems and Interaction Group at Microsoft Research in Redmond. I've joined Microsoft Research in 2007, and pretty much ever since, my research has focused on issues of physically situated interaction. Basically, how can we get computers to reason more deeply about their surroundings, understand how people behave and interact with each other in physical space, and participate in these interactions in a fluid manner? Now, over the years, we've studied a number of problems in this space and develop a variety of prototype interactive systems, from virtual assistants that live outside your office door and interact with people that come by when you're not present to perhaps negotiate some calendaring tasks on your behalf, to robots that give directions in the building with coordinated pointing and gaze and gesture and speech, all the way to elevators that recognize intentions to board or walk by. These type of systems that reason about and act in the physical world are generally multimodal and integrative in nature. That means they leverage many different kinds of streaming data and bring together different kinds of AI technologies to solve an end-to-end problem. For instance, in my own work, I've been very interested in how physically situated language interaction works. How can we get computers to understand the finely coordinated dance that we do with each other when we interact with spoken language in face-to-face settings, with all the coordination that happens in our verbal and nonverbal behaviors? Clearly, to construct interactive systems like this, we need to leverage data from both the audio and visual domains, and we need to bring to bear a lot of different AI technologies. Now, over the last decade, we've seen a lot of significant progress with machine learning techniques and large data sets on a number of core important AI problems in computer vision, speech recognition, a variety of natural language processing tasks. And this is very exciting because these perceptual technologies are basically the core building blocks required to get computers to start to understand the physical world. Now, despite the progress that we've made though, putting these technologies together and constructing end-to-end systems that operate seamlessly in the real world remains a very challenging task from an engineering standpoint, even if we leave aside all the scientific challenges that might arise in any specific application. And I would argue that a lot of these engineering challenges stem, on one hand, from the sheer complexity of these systems. As we said, they use many different kinds of components. And on the other hand, from the fact that the infrastructures and programming fabrics and the tools we use to develop these systems today are not very well attuned to the needs of these applications. As I've mentioned before, the systems that reason about the world generally process multimodal data streams in real time. So images, audio, depth maps, LiDAR information, this data comes streaming with different bandwidth and different latency requirements. The processing often involves a heterogeneous set of components, from sensor-specific SDKs and drivers, to machine learned models that trigger large GPU loads, to cloud services, to integration with application-specific backend logics. Now, for these kind of systems that operate in the world, time is also very important. And so the execution of these components needs to be very finely coordinated and done in a very efficient manner because these systems often operate under important latency constraints. And oftentimes when you build these systems, you find yourself developing low-level, you know, synchronization or fusion problems or optimizing something or building logging infrastructure instead of really focusing on the task at hand. So over the years, we've encountered many of these challenges firsthand, and I believe that anyone that has tried to build one of these multimodal, real-time, integrative AI applications has probably seen them as well. And so based on all these lessons learned, as well as experiences people on our team have had in robotics domains, we have developed at Microsoft Research a framework that aims to alleviate these engineering challenges and accelerate research and development for these multimodal integrative AI applications. The framework is called Platform for Situated Intelligence, and it is open source and available online at github.com/microsoft/sci. So Platform for Situated Intelligence is built on top of .NET. So it runs cross-platform on both Windows and Linux, and it retains the modern affordances of programming languages like C# and F#, so things like type safety and memory management, while addressing the very specific needs that multimodal integrative AI applications have. Concretely, the framework provides affordances in three different areas: infrastructure, components, and tools. With respect to infrastructure, the Platform for Situated Intelligence Runtime provides a programming model for working with multimodal temporally streaming data, in which applications are composed by connecting components together with streams of data. Time is a first-order object in this framework. Messages that flow through the processing pipeline are timestamped at the source when they are acquired from the world with something we refer to as an originating time. And this originating time automatically carries through downstream in the entire computation pipeline, enable latency awareness, as well as correct and reproducible synchronization and data fusion anywhere downstream. This is a very important property in these systems. And apart from this, the infrastructure provides a number of other benefits, including data logging and data replay, component isolation, remoting, and so on. For instance, data streams can be easily logged to disk and then resurfaced from disk later, simulating a live execution, which enables a data-driven development cycle where you repeatedly experiment over the same data and tune and improve your components over time. So apart from the infrastructure, the framework comes also with an open, growing ecosystem of components that wrap various sensor technologies like microphones, cameras, Azure Kinect device, and various processing technologies for processing images and audio, speech, language, running pre-existing machine learning Onyx models, or connecting to various cloud services. The basic idea is that to write an application, you'd hopefully find a lot of available off-the-shelf components and you connect them together, and perhaps you write a couple of components that are specific to your particular application. So for example, in one of our introductory demo samples we have in the repo, we instantiate an Azure Kinect camera. We perform body tracking based on the Azure Kinect. We detect when the person raises their arm and points and compute the direction in which they're pointing. We intersect that direction with a depth mesh and take that orange intersection point and project it back into the RGB camera of the Azure Kinect sensor. We crop an image patch around that projection point and send that up to Azure Computer Vision Service to do object detection. In parallel with all of this, we capture data audio from a microphone and segment it using voice activity detector and perform speech recognition, again, using cloud services. The idea being that you can walk into a room, point to an object, say, what is that? And the computer understands what you're pointing at. Now, this is just a small sample application. It's a couple of hundred lines of code. It's available in the repository. And in reality, applications developed with this framework can grow significantly more sophisticated than this. But this is just meant to illustrate the ease with which you can connect a variety of different components together, from streams coming from an Azure Kinect sensors, to cloud services for computer vision and speech recognition, to locally performed computations to detect when someone is pointing and the direction they're pointing into, and so on. Now, when you write this type of applications, another big part of development has to do with debugging, maintenance, and iterative improvement. The framework provides a companion tool called Platform for Situated Intelligence Studio, which allows developers to visualize streams of data persisted by applications written using this framework. It's very easy to construct complex visualization layouts that involve timeline visualizers for numerical data and audio and so on, 2D visualizers, things like images, object detection results, 3D visualizers, point clouds, track bodies, camera views. And it's very easy to inspect this data. You can do so over time. You can navigate easily over time and inspect what happened in the application at different time points. And this can significantly accelerate the debugging and maintenance process. The visualizations can be done not only offline based on persisted data, but also live while the application is running. Also, apart from visualization, the tool supports data annotation and batch processing, which are, again, constructs that are very important when you're dealing with these data-driven development loops. Altogether, we believe this set of tools, together with the infrastructure provided by the runtime and the set of components available, can significantly accelerate work for multimodal integrative AI applications. So in case you think this might be interesting for your own work, please check it out. As I mentioned, the framework is open source, available at github.com/microsoft/sci. We have a lot of documentation, which is hosted in the wiki pages on the GitHub site. And on the right-hand side, there's a sidebar that essentially provides an index into the various documentation topics. The best place probably to get started learning about the framework and coding with Platform for Situated Intelligence is the brief introduction tutorial that introduces some of the main concepts step by step. I would also recommend probably perusing some of the samples that we have in the repo. A lot of these samples have detailed walkthroughs that walk you step by step through how the sample was built and point to more in-depth documentation in relevant places. The samples vary in complexity. They start with simple ones that just illustrate how do I construct the first pipeline and create a first stream, to how do I capture, you know, audio and video data from a webcam and a microphone, all the way to the more sophisticated sample I just described, where you're able to point to objects in a room and the machine understands what exactly you're pointing to. Apart from the GitHub repo, a recent blog post that provides a high-level overview of the framework, and also a webinar that's available online, which apart from the overview of the framework also contains a 30-minute hands-on coding tutorial, how to get started with Platform for Situated Intelligence. Platform for Situated Intelligence is the result of the work of a team of talented engineers and researchers at Microsoft Research, and I want to thank and acknowledge them here. So we're looking forward to engaging with a broader community and growing this open source effort. We encourage you to use the framework and contribute. No contribution is too small. From simply filing issues when you find bugs and giving us feedback, to developing your own components and contributing them or releasing them yourself, to developing entirely new features. We look forward to hearing from you, and we hope Platform for Situated Intelligence will accelerate your work.
We have to actually rethink the entire AI stack.
What is reinforcement learning? Let's look at an interactive demo.
All our code is now open source.